गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माई चैनल। टुडे आई एम कमिंग विथ अ न्यू वीडियो एंड माई टुडेज टॉपिक इज स्टार्टर फॉर द डीसी मोटर। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द नेसेसिटी ऑफ द डीसी मोटर स्टार्टर, व्हाई इट इज नीडेड, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द स्टार्टर, एंड देन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वर्किंग ऑफ अ थ्री पॉइंट स्टार्टर। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। व्हाट इज द नेसेसिटी ऑफ द स्टार्टर? This is the equation of the DC motor. Back EMF EB is equals to V minus IaRa. So what is the value of the armature current at starting? So Ia is equals to, from this equation, Ia is equals to V minus EB divided by the Ra. Here Ia is the armature current, V is the supplied voltage, EB is the back EMF, and Ra is the armature resistance. And we are knowing that in the DC motor, this back EMF is proportional to the speed. EB is directly proportional to the speed N. So what happen during the starting? When the motor is at rest, the speed is equals to zero. So back EMF is proportional to speed. So back EMF is also zero. Now if we put the value of EB is equals to 0 in this equation, we get a very higher value of the armature current. So due to the high starting current, the DC motor has the following risk, which I have mentioned here. Which are the risk? Number one, the armature of the motor can be burned. As the value of the armature current is very much high, so the armature of the motor can be burned. Number two, voltage drop in the line is increasing, so equipment connected with the same line will get the lesser voltage, right? If the armature current is very much high or the starting current is very much high, voltage drop in the line will become more, so the other equipment connected with the line will get the less voltage. At the same time, if the starting current is high, we will get a heavy sparking in the commutator and the brushes of the DC motor. And due to the higher starting current, it will increase the mechanical stress on the DC motor. So from all these four effect, we can conclude that the starter for the DC motor is very much needed to control the high starting current, to reduce the starting current to a very safer value, right? Now in this video, we will talk about a three-point starter for the DC shunt motor and the DC compound motor. We will discuss the construction of the three-point starter, right? This is the figure of the three-point starter. So first of all, let us discuss the construction point of the three-point starter. As its name indicates, three points means it has the three terminal, namely L, it is connected to the positive terminal of the supply mains. L is the line which is directly connected to positive of the supply. A means armature, A is connected to the armature, and F is the field winding which is connected to the field winding. So as its name, three point starter, these are the three terminal: line, armature and field, right? Here F and A, field and the armature, the other two terminal of the field and the armature winding are connected. You can see from the figure that the second terminal of the field winding and the second terminal of the armature winding, these two connections are connected to the negative terminal of the DC supply, right? So this is the three point: line, armature and the field. Now which are the different parts of the three point starter? Here I have given the name. The first one, starting resistance. Second, no voltage coil, or we can also say the hold on coil. Third is the moving arm. This is the moving arm. Fourth one, it is the overload coil. As you can see here, overload coil. This is fifth one, is the spring, and sixth is the soft iron piece which is attached to this moringa. So let us discuss the construction and the working of these six parts. First part is starting resistance. These are the resistance R1, R2, R3, R4 and R5. The starter consists of the several section of the starting resistance. As you can see, all the tapping points of the starting resistance are connected to the number of studs R1, R2, R3. These are the number of studs. The main function of this resistance is to limit the starting current of the motor. The major function of the starting resistance, as you can see, that this starting resistance are connected in the series with the armature. So what happen? The armature current, the starting current value, can be reduced by using this resistance. Second one is the hold on coil or the no voltage coil. This is the hold on coil or the no voltage coil. What is the function of the hold on coil? The hold on coil or the no voltage coil is connected in series with this field winding. The main function of this hold on coil is to hold the moving arm when the motor is in normal condition. This is the moving arm, right? This is the off position, this is the on position. When this moving arm is in on position, it will held by this hold on coil or the no voltage coil, but it will held this moving arm, so it is also called hold on coil, right? Now coming to the next part, moving arm. What is the importance of the moving arm? So you can see that the one end of the moving arm, which is highlighted here, is connected to the line terminal, right? It is connected to the L terminal, but via overload coil. Look at here. This moving arm is connected to the L terminal, but it is connected via overload coil, and the other end makes the contact with the stud during the operation. So what is its main function? Its main function is to cut out this resistance, right? The main functions of this moving arm is to cut out this resistance, which are connected in series with this armature, right? The next part is the spring. The spring is connected with moving arm. This spring, as you can see, is connected with this moving arm. What is the function of the spring? The main function of the spring is to provide controlling torque to this moving arm. This spring will provide a controlling torque to this moving arm. Next one and the last, soft iron piece. You can see here a soft iron piece is attached with this moving arm. So what happens during the normal operation of the motor, when this moving arm is coming into this side, what happens? It is attracted by the hold on coil and it will keep the motor in on position. Last thing is this overload coil. What is the function of this overload coil? So this overload coil is connected in series with the line. You can see that this overload coil is connected in series with the line. So its main function is to protect the motor from the load. This overload coil will protect the motor from the load. So these are the main component as far as the 3-point starter of DC shunt motor and DC compound motor is concerned. Now we will discuss the working principle of the 3-point starter, how it will work. So first of all, switch on the main supply. This is the main DC supply. Switch on the main supply with 3-point. Switch on the main supply, but you have to keep this moving arm in the off position, right? Now what happen when the moving arm with the help of the handle come into the first stud, right? So this resistance will be come into the picture. when the moving arms come in contact with the first stud, the field winding, which field winding? This is the field winding. When this moving arm, it is coming in the contact with the first stud, this field winding, right? This is the field winding, is directly connected to the supply mains, while the whole starting resistance are connected in series with the armature. So what happen? These all resistance will come in the picture, and the armature resistance RA and the whole starting resistance RA will be limited, right? So that is the functions of the resistance. Now what happen when this moving arm is on? It will be kept on, it will be held by this no voltage coil or the hold on coil, right? Now if there is a overload, if there is a overcurrent, at that time what happen? At that time you can see this is a armature. This armature is attracted. So these two points, look at here, these two points will be short, and these two points will be directly connected to the field. So the field current, this no voltage coil or the hold on coil will demagnetize, and as this hold on coil or the no voltage coil will be demagnetized, it is not in a position to hold on this moving arm and it will come back. So when this handle is come back, then it cannot start directly. We have to start by some other means, right? So this is the how the three point starter is working. Let us discuss one important drawback of the three point starter as well. We can see that the field winding is connected in this way. Now what happen? Suppose we have to control the speed of the DC motor, then if we are changing the field current, if we are decreasing the field current to a very low value, then what happen? The field current will be less. So this hold on coil or the no voltage coil will not in a position to hold on this moving arm, and though there is no fault in the DC machine, but though your supply will be cut out and motor will be in off positions. So this is the limitations of the 3-point starter, which is removed in the 4-point starter. I hope friends you understand why the starter is needed for the DC shunt and compound motor, what is the importance of this starter, what is the functions of this starter, and 3-point starter's construction as well as working. Please like my video, share your valuable comments. Thank you.